So welcome, today we're gonna talk about the Dragon Quest Heroes 2. The Dragon Quest Heroes 2 is a hack and slash game which was developed by the Omega Force and published under Square Enix for PlayStation 4, PS3, Vita, Nintendo Switch and Microsoft Windows. It's originally released in Japan 2016 and arrived in April 2017. And this part is the sequel of the Quest Heroes, The World Tree's Woe and The Blight Below. So it's quite of the mix of the hack and slash combat of the Dynasty Warrior series, if you know. And the characters, monster, and the universe from the Square Enix Dragon Quest series. So it's a combine of those two games. And it is pointed that this game is actually weighted on the RPG elements than most of the Omega Force other titles. World exploration is actually resemble the typical of Dragon Quest experience. Players can move to other towns, move to another area within the exploration maps, and they can switch parties. And what I like about this game is actually this kind of the ultimate skill is pretty much great and awesome. So this game kind of reminded me of the RPG game which is Sword Art Online Holo Realization and with all other Sword Art Online series. And if you compare this game to the SOA, this game has a definitive experience which is different from that one. You can see that the graphic is much pretty much different, and also the combination of technique skills is different with the Sword Art Holo Realization. But comparing both of them is not pretty much fair because each of them has different kind of style of play and kind of style of the fun. The what different is the significant difference is that here you can get a lot of monsters, a lot of seamless random monster which you can encounter, which may break up the pace between locations. And from all of that monster you can summon the monster. It's different with the Sword Art Online, which is you cannot have the summoned monster. It's pretty much hack and slash and killing all the enemies and getting open up locations. But here it is more simpler. Leave it to me. And also the ultimate skill is pretty much awesome and so animative. So I give a thumbs up on the Dragon Quest Heroes 2. Besides all the skill and also the ultimate skills and all the quests here is and also the monster, the lore, the universe, all the open world is cuter than the other games. It has a great animation also. Besides that, you can have the special ingredients and the treasure box, which can be discovered across the world map. The treasure box is great for getting a great weapon items, which actually you can buy directly to the shop in the Arcadia, the place where you begin your quest. So the Dragon Quest Heroes 2 is actually a connection between the monster and the character itself. It can build up a strategy, a good strategy to kill enemies, higher level enemies and rare monster with the a monster itself that we can gain within the game, within the area, in a manner, in a form of coins. And besides that, weather is can actually fluctuate and affect the party status. For example, in the rainy days, which inflicts a curse or ailment on the party during battle. You know, the Square Enix is pretty much about the Final Fantasy XV, and there is of course ailments, element there. And the combination is you can have really have you can differentiate between the games which is under Square Enix and under other publisher. Nice work, everyone. So the character is able to dash also to wherever they please. They can use, you can run here by using, by clicking the R2 button, and also you can zoom in to any, you can teleport to any location that you want. But being said that, the certain areas actually block until the player proceeds with the main story, like the area in the Grand Dunes, which is pretty much blocked. But when you have proceed with the main story and you have assemble your team which has magic and also the technique, physical technique, those blocks area which is actually was blocked by a storm and also a wall, is you can just make it open with your party. So as you can see, this animation is pretty much great, and I think that in a matter of the graphic itself and also the combat style experience, I could enjoy it. And if a player, a character die, you can just switch character and just continue on with the characters. But as any other RPG game, you have to measure your ability to kill the enemies, which is maybe higher than your level. It can be pretty much hard, and you can evac if you found out that a monster or enemies that you have is too much for you. Basically, the effect system can get you back to the Arcadia, which you can save your program, your progress. So in case of the item itself, you will have the orb, you will have the accessories, you will have the weapons, the shields, which you can purchase or gain in certain quests. But you cannot upgrade that weapon, so it's better just buy a higher grade weapons and sell whatever lower weapons. And for the accessories itself, you can buy it in the shop, and you can upgrade it to higher levels with the sufficient ingredients that you can acquire and obtain during any quest or during your killing on the enemies or monsters. Ready? Since the character itself is pretty much a few, and it's not limited to one or two characters, experiencing the other characters and the style of play is pretty much satisfying. And besides that, you can also change your vocation between these two main character, the girl and also the boy. You can choose to be a priest, you can choose to be a kung fu master, things like that, by using the goal.
Did you have fun? I know I did.
So this is the result of your quest. You can have the items there, and you can allocate skills here within all of the characters, and also you can set your skill different for each character. And you can set the spells and also the abilities that you acquire in the allocated skills, so you can put your skills here. So currently the two players co-op is now available for the main story by selecting the assist option in the main battle menu. Well, alternatively players can work together to complete the new Time Labyrinth. It is a series of the multiplayer exclusive stages which aim to appeal a long time Dragon Quest fans. And it is unlocked by finding the labyrinth map placed scattered throughout the main story. So just talk to Erin in the town inns to set up online matching and send invites. And you can play up to 4 player together in the multiplayer mission. Online chat is not available, but well, player can select common stock phrase to communicate.
If I'm thoughtless, then what are you? Or have you forgotten all the stupid things I've seen you do? Prince Pouselot.
How terribly sophisticated you've become. Why?
Stop it, both of you. Is this really the time or the place for your bickering? In case you've forgotten, we came here to try and talk Cesar around.
Talk me round? Am I to take this to mean you have turned your coats and sided with the Harbans?
So the story actually takes place in the peaceful land of Seven Kingdoms, which is suddenly as though enchanted by the ancient prophecy, the kingdoms which war. And the heroes from different kingdoms band together to restore peace to their torn continents. So, with that being said, Dragon Quest Heroes 2 was developed with by Omega Force, who are better known for their Dynasty Warrior hack and slash series. Dragon Heroes 1 to 2, a compilation featuring both games in the series, actually released as a Japanese launch title for the Nintendo Switch on March 2017. So this game actually awarded with the 4 scores of 10, which is equal to the 39 out of 40, and more than 500,000 copies are being sold in Japan. So that's why they spreading around the world and see that it can go higher revenue in this game. So as you can see here, that the battle system itself is pretty much awesome for you to experience, and it's a workout for the satisfactory experience. Basically, you can increase your level and items by doing more killing on the enemies, and also the multiple quests that you can acquire in the Arcadia in the certain vendor type of place. Begun.
Lucky me. Ready?
You better be.
So I think that's the end of my review on this awesome Dragon Quest Heroes 2. So please tell me what you think about this game, if you want to play, if you can play it, and it's not pretty much expensive to purchase this game. And please don't forget to subscribe and give me comments on my review on this game. And see you on another review. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and bye-bye.
If you work hard, you can achieve anything.